morning. Today we'll clear the concept of discounts.
Now imagine that the marked price of a product is 100 rupees. Okay, and you give a 20% discount. So what does that mean? You are selling the product at actually 80%. So what is the selling price? That marked price into 0.8. 80%, 0.8. And how do you get this 80%? That is actually 100 minus given discount 20 upon 100. So if the discount is X percent, you can write 1 minus X by 100, or you can write 100 minus X by 100. So this is the selling price, that is you sold the product at 80 rupees. So what can be the formula from this? Selling price is equal to marked price into 1 minus X by 100, or marked price 100 minus X by 100. Now this is the first discount. This is discount number 1. Now if you give another discount, after giving 20% discount, you have given another 10% discount. That means now you have sold the product for 90%. So you will multiply by 0.9. So what is the new selling price? After giving discount, first discount it was 80 rupees, into now you have given another discount. So this answer is 72 rupees. So how do you get the formula for successive discount? Marked price, 1 minus X1 by 100, and again you are multiplied with the next discount. So in this case it was 100 into, after first discount was 20%, so you multiplied by 0.8, next discount was 10%, so you multiplied by 0.9. So again the answer is 72 rupees. So from this you have understood two formulas. If there is a discount X, then the factor to multiply is 1 minus X by 100, or 100 minus X by 100, whichever you feel comfortable. And when there is a discount, how do you find selling price? Selling price is equal to marked price into 1 minus X by 100. And if there are successive discount, then selling price is equal to, you just have to keep multiplying by the number of discounts, the marked price into 1 minus X1 by 100, 1 minus X2 by 100. If there is a third discount, then 1 minus X3 by 100. So this was the concept of successive discount. Now let us see what is effective discount. Let us continue with the same example. In the previous example, a product of 100 rupees was given a 20% discount and we sold it for 80 rupees. Again, 10% was given and we sold it for 72 rupees. So how much is the effective discount? Is it 20 plus 10? Is it 30%? No, because if it was 30%, then this value would be 70 rupees. 70 plus 30 is 100. So it is not 30%. So what is the effective discount? 100 minus 72. So the effective discount is only 28%. So this is effective discount and this is the discount if it was given 30% discount. So what is better, giving a lump sum discount of 30% or multiple discounts? Multiple discounts, because ultimately you are saving little bit, like instead of 70 rupees you can sell it at 72 rupees. So how do you find this? What is the formula for effective discount? Instead of solving step by step, finding the final price and then subtracting it from the original price, then you have to find what is the percentage discount. That is a lengthy process. So the formula is, if there are two discounts, say X1 and X2, then effective discount is X1 plus X2 minus X1 X2 by 100. Let us apply and see. What was the first discount? 20%. What was the second discount? 10%. Minus 20 into 10 by 100. So that is 30% minus, this is how much? 3. So that comes out to be, this is actually 2. 20 into 10, 200 and 100 cancels out, so 2. So you get 28%. So this is the formula for effective discount. So I hope you understood the concept of successive discount and effective discount and how to find selling price when there is a discount. Now we'll see some questions from ATC paper. So in this question, marked price is given as 450 and discount x is equal to 20%. So if 20% discount is given, that means they have sold it at 80%. So selling price is equal to 450 into 0.8, answer 360. This question, first discount x1 is 20%, second discount is 10%, and third discount is 15%. So for x1 plus x2, what is the effective discount? Just now we have discussed the formula. 20 plus 10 minus 20 into 10 by 100. So this becomes 30 minus 2, 28%. Now for this is the x1, this is the x2. So now what is the effective discount? 28 plus 15 minus 28 into 15 by 100. So this comes out to be 43 minus, this is 420 upon 100, so 4.2. So effective discount is 38.8%. Now let's see one tough question. This is from 2023 ATC paper. So here the marked price is 450. It is sold for 348.48 after giving two successive discounts. If single discount is given, then what is the selling price? So let us see how to solve this question.
So marked price is 450. Selling price is marked price into the first discount x percent, so 1 minus x by 100, into another discount x percent, so 1 minus x by 100. So you equate this, find the value of x. Now in the second part, selling price is 450 into 1 minus, now discount is 2x, so 2x by 100.